The fast road. There used to be one road that got you to wherever you wanted to go much quicker than any other road. It looked like a perfectly ordinary road, but the moment you stepped onto it, you got to wherever it was you wanted to go. That is, if you knew where you wanted to go. Unfortunately, most folk weren't absolutely sure. They liked the idea of getting somewhere so much that they often stepped onto the road before they'd really decided where it was they wanted to end up. And when you did that, this is what would happen. You'd step onto the road and start walking. For a moment it would seem just like walking along any old road. But then as you walked on a bit further, you'd find the countryside slipping past as though you were running, even though you were still just walking. The next minute, the countryside would be speeding past as if you were galloping on a horse. And before you knew it, there would be just a blur on either side of you, and the world flashed past quicker than the eye could see. And if you didn't know where you were going, you would just go on getting faster and faster and faster and faster. Until all of a sudden, see this. Nothing. Nothing to your left. Nothing to your right. Nothing in front of you. Nothing behind you. Nothing. Nothing, that is, except for people wandering around quite lost. Well, here is the story of a girl named Poppy who stepped onto the fast road and didn't have the first clue where she was heading. The moment she stepped onto the fast road, she had an idea that something was going to happen, but she couldn't imagine what. To begin with, it was just like walking along any other road. But soon she noticed the countryside slipping past faster than she was walking. Then before she could work out what was happening, she found the countryside whizzing past her as if she was galloping on a horse. The next minute, it was all a blur, flashing past her on both sides, so fast that she couldn't make anything out. It was just a blur of green. the sheep like stripes and brown and white. It all went faster and faster. Faster and faster and faster and faster until all of a sudden it stopped. Poppy almost fell over herself, it was so sudden. But she shook her head and looked around, and do you know what she saw? Nothing. Nothing to her left. Nothing to her right. Nothing in front of her. Nothing behind her. There were plenty of people wandering around her, but she could see they were quite lost. Well, Poppy picked herself up and said, "Well, I wonder where I am." Then she stepped off the fast road and walked across the flat nothingness towards the horizon. After a while, she saw something in the distance. And as she got nearer, she saw it was a strange building. It was as tall as a mountain, and it was full of people. But the really extraordinary thing was that the building didn't have an inside. It was all outside. At the bottom was a man behind a desk. "Can you tell me where I am?" said Poppy.
"Well, this is nowhere in particular," replied the man. "Would you like to sign the guest book?"
"I'll not sign the book because I'm not stopping, but is it all right if I look around?"
"Help yourself, there's nothing particular here."
So Poppy climbed the stairs that led all around the outside of the building. First floor, she met a family who were sitting on stools looking at a stone. "What on earth are you doing?" asked Poppy. "We're stone watching," replied the whole family without taking their eyes off the stone. "Stone watching? I've never heard of such a thing. Isn't it extremely boring?" "Oh no," exclaimed the farmer. "But stones don't do anything." "But this one might," exclaimed the mother. "And we'll be the first to see it when he does," exclaimed the children. "Why don't you come and join us?"